Now let's come to the last video of this particular chapter and talk about a simple question on the topic of stagnation properties. The question says, find the Mach number when an aeroplane is flying at 1100 kmph through still air, having a pressure of 7 newtons per centimeter square and temperature of minus 5 degrees Celsius. Consider the wind velocity 0, the R is 287.14, and we need to find out the stagnation pressure, stagnation density and stagnation temperature. Okay. Now, the velocity is given to you as 1100 kmph. Let's convert this into meters per second, so that I'll have to multiply with 1000 and divide by 60 by 60. Okay. This would give you a value which is approximately 306 meters per second. Now, with this in place, what is the value of R? R is 287.14. This is joules, kg Kelvin. And the temperature is given to us as minus 5 degrees Celsius, which is 268 Kelvin. Okay. And the adiabatic index is 1.4. So, this gives us a value of the velocity of sound, which is 1.4 into 287.14 into 268. That's the temperature. Okay. So, when you calculate this, you get a speed velocity of sound as 328.2 meters per second. Okay. Now, you have velocity in meters per second and you have the velocity of sound in meters per second. This can give you Mach number, which is the velocity upon the speed of sound, which is 0.931. This is the Mach number. Okay, so with Mach number in place, now we can start finding out the stagnation properties. So PS is P1, if P1 is given to you as 7 newton per centimeter square, so this would be 7 into 10 to the power 4 pascals. Okay, so you will have P1 into 1 plus k minus 1 by 2 into m square to the power k upon k minus 1. So, plug in the value, so you have 7 into 10 to the power 4 into 1 plus 0.4 by 2 into 0.931 square upon 1.4 by 0.4. So, upon calculating this, then let's divide the entire thing by 10 to the power 4 so as to get the answer in newton per centimeter square only. This would become 12.24 newton per centimeter square. So, that is the value of your stagnation pressure. Simple formula application, nothing more. Okay. Then TS is T1 into 1 plus k minus 1 by 2 into Mach square. Okay. When you put in the values over here, you get a value in Kelvin. Remember, because this would be in Kelvin, 268. It would be 314.44 Kelvin. Okay. So, this in degree would be 41.44 degrees Celsius. Now, with pressure over here, temperature over here, and the value of R known to us, we can easily find out the stagnation density. And stagnation density would be PS upon R into TS. So, PS is 12.24 10 to the power 4 upon 287.14 into 268. This gives you a value of 1.355 kg per meter cube. Alright, so this is the stagnation density, this is the stagnation pressure, and this is the stagnation temperature. So, this is as simple as it can get. So, I hope you got an idea of what do we have in store for compressible flow in gate. So, now let's move on to the next topic and start talking about the impact of jets and jet propulsion.